Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the lecture series of digital signal processing. So today in this session we are going to discuss two problems on the partial fraction expansion method, so which is nothing but the method to form inverse Z transform. So we have already started the inverse Z transform. I have made 2 to 3 videos on how to find inverse Z transform of the given signals. Okay, that means we are converting frequency domain signal into time domain signal. That means x of z will be converted to the x of n. Okay, so this is the inverse z transform, that is conversion of frequency domain signal into time domain signal. So in this lecture we are going to discuss two more problems on the inverse z transform using partial fraction expansion method. We already covered one more method, that is long division method. I have made 2 videos on the long division method, you should watch that. So along with that we are covering now the partial fraction expansion method. So let's discuss the given problem of the partial fraction expansion method. So the given problem is obtain inverse z transform of the following. So the equation is given, x of z is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 z raised to minus 1 divided by 1 minus 1 by 4 z raised to minus 2, where condition is given, which is nothing but the ROC condition, that is mod of z is greater than 1 by 2. So as we know, the first step will be check the given equation which is in the proper form or not. So the given equation is in the proper form. If you see the values of a0, m and n, okay. So let's check the powers of z. Okay, this next step will be powers of z. Let's check the powers of z. So there is a rule that there should be positive powers of z in the equation. Okay, so the given equation should be in the positive powers of z. Okay, positive powers of z, but in the equation it is given that there is a numerator, that is z raised to minus 1, and at the denominator there is a z raised to minus 2. So this is not in proper form, so we have to convert this negative powers of z into positive powers of z. Okay, this is the requirement to solve partial fraction method. So how we can do that? Just multiply numerator and denominator by z square. Okay, so just multiplying z square to numerator and denominator of the given equation, we will get positive powers of z. So after multiplying z square with the numerator and denominator, we are getting x of z is equal to z square, okay, z square minus 1 by 2 z divided by again z square minus 1 by 4. So this z raised to minus 2 gets cancelled. Because of what? We are multiplying z raised to z square to the z raised to minus 2, so minus plus become 0, so anything raised to 0 is 1. Okay, so ultimately we are getting, after multiplying z square, we have this equation, that is x of z is equal to z square minus 1 by 4 z divided by z square minus 1 by 4. This is the equation. So let's solve the next step. I think you have watched my earlier video that there is a 5 to 6 step to solve any partial fraction expansion method. So the next step will be obtain the given equation in this form, that is x of z divided by z. Okay, that means just convert this equation into this form, that is x of z divided by z. So what we can do, we just put z common. Okay, we can put the z common from this equation. So we are getting z into in bracket z minus 1 by 2 divided by z square minus 1 by 4. Okay, which just we have put the take the common z from this numerator. Okay, we have taken this z common from the numerator, so ultimately we get z into z minus 1 by 2 at the numerator, and divided by z square minus 1 by 4 is as it is. So this is the step 3. Okay, step 3 is what? Just obtain this equation into x of z divided by z form. So ultimately we are getting x of z divided by z. This z comes here at the denominator of x of z. So remaining will be z minus 1 by 2 divided by z square minus 1 by 4. So this is the proper form of the step 3. Now the step 4 is the just obtain the roots of the denominator. Okay, just we have to obtain the roots of the denominator. So this is the denominator, that is z square minus 1 by 4. So ultimately we know that minus 1 by 2 square is the 1 by 4. Okay, so ultimately the roots become, so in this way we can write this z square minus 1 by 2 square. So after getting this, this is the same, just we are putting 1 by 4 instead of, we are putting 1 by 2 whole square instead of 1 by 4. Okay, so the roots become, just take first z minus 1 by 2 from this and next z plus 1 by 2. So these are the roots of the denominator. Okay, that is z minus 1 by 2 and z plus 1 by 2. So next find out the values of p1 and p2. These are nothing but the poles. So how we can find out the values? So p1 ultimately what? Z minus p1. So p1 is nothing but 1 by 2. Okay, and p2 is minus 1 by 2. Okay, so just obtaining the roots of the denominator, we can find out the values of p1 and p2. So p1 is nothing but, here is z minus 1 by 2. Okay, so z is equal to 1 by 2, which is nothing but the p1, and p2 is this z plus 1 by 2. So value become p2 is equal to minus 1 by 2. So this is the values of p1 and p2. So ultimately we find out the roots of this equation. The next thing will be just obtain the given equation in the partial fraction form. Okay, the next step will be, we have to arrange the equation in the partial fraction form. So just put these values here first. Okay, so wait a minute. Now this is the numerator. Okay, this is ours the required equation, and the denominator we find out these roots, that is z minus 1 by 2 into z plus 1 by 2. So as we observe, this z, this thing and this thing will cancel. Okay, this term and this term will cancel. So remaining will be 1 upon z plus 1 by 2. Okay, so this is nothing but our x of z divided by z, which is nothing but 1 upon z plus 1 by 2. So next thing will be the partial fraction expansion form. So this is the expansion form of the partial fraction, that is x of z is equal to a1 divided by z minus p1. So what we get, the a1 is 1. Okay, this is the a1, so we don't have to calculate this value. So just by observing our equation, that is x of z divided by z, we ultimately get a1 is equal to 1. Okay. Now as we know, we have a1 is equal to 1, just find out the last sequence, that is x of n. So now the equation is given, become x of z is equal to z upon z plus 1. Okay, so ultimately it is multiplied with the a1. So this function is causal. Okay, this function is the causal if mod of z should be greater than minus 1 by 2. Mod of z should be greater than 1 by 2, and the given ROC is, again, mod of z should be greater than 1 by 2. Okay, so as we know, as we have discussed in the last session, what is the inverse z transform of this term? To find inverse z transform of this term, just use this standard formula. Okay, this is the standard formula to find out inverse z transform. What it shows, it shows that IZT, which is inverse z transform of z upon z minus pk, okay, z upon z minus pk, is nothing but the pk into u of n, okay, which is what? Pk into u of n. So just compare this formula with our equation. So what we are getting, we get this is pk, okay, 1 by 2 is nothing but the pk, so it will become minus, okay, here is a minus, then it will become plus. So the equation becomes minus 1 by 2 into u of n, okay. Just we have compared the standard formula of inverse Z transform with the our equation, okay. So after using this formula, we are getting minus 1 by 2 raised to n into u of n. So this is the final equation of the inverse Z transform, and in this way we have find out the inverse Z transform of the given standard pair. So I think you got this problem, which was very simple. The main thing is that just you have to remember the steps, okay. First thing, just see the given problem which is in the proper format or not, okay. Then just check whether there is a powers of Z or is the negative or positive. We should have all the powers of Z should be in the positive form. There should be no negative form of this power. So for this purpose, we just multiply Z square to the numerator and denominator. So ultimately, again, we obtain our equation in the X of Z divided by Z form by just taking Z common from this term. Okay. The next step was to find the roots of denominator. So in this way, we have find the roots of denominator, the first root and the second root. And using this root, we simply find out the values of P1 and P2. We put the value here. Okay. So these two becomes gets cancelled, and this is our equation, that is X of Z is equal to 1 upon Z plus 1 by 2. So the next thing was the obtain the value of A1. So by using the equation, just simply obtain the value of A1 is 1, okay. And we have this standard equation formula, that is Z upon Z plus 1 by 2 is what? Its inverse Z transform is what? Minus 1 by 2 into u of n by using this standard formula, okay. So this was a very simple example on the inverse Z transform. We will discuss one more example on it. Example is the, we have to find inverse Z transform of this sequence causal signal, okay. Determine the causal signal X of n or obtain the Z transform of this term. X of Z is given. So again, check whether the powers of Z are the negative or positive. So as we have standard rule, there is all positive powers of Z. So if we see, there is a minus 1 is there. Again here minus 2 is there, powers of Z. Again there is a negative powers of Z. So how we can obtain this? Just multiply numerator and denominator by Z square again. Please correct it, here is a Z square. So after multiplying Z square with the numerator and denominator, we get this term, that is X of Z is equal to Z square plus 3Z divided by Z square plus 3Z plus 2. Then we can put, the next step was the, just take common Z from this numerator and obtain the equation in this form, that is the X of Z divided by Z. We have to obtain the given equation in this form. This is mandatory. So how we can do this step? Just take Z common from the numerator. So after taking Z from the numerator, this Z comes here divided by X of Z. So X of Z divided by Z is equal to Z plus 3 divided by Z plus 1 into Z plus 2. So this is nothing but the roots of this equation, that is Z square plus 3Z plus 1. So by finding out the roots, we will have Z plus 1 into Z plus 2. Okay. Now the again equation become very easier to solve. So obtain the given equation in the partial fraction form. So this is the partial fraction form of the given equation, that is X of Z divided by Z, A1 divided by Z plus 1, the first term, and A2 divided by Z plus 2, which is the second term. So obtain the values of A1 and A2. So this is the standard formula to obtain the values of A1. So A1 becomes Z plus 1, okay, into X of Z divided by Z, okay, Z plus 1 into X of Z divided by Z. So what is X of Z divided by Z? This term, that is Z plus 3 divided by Z plus 1 into Z plus 2. Just put it here, okay. This is the standard formula to find out A1. So how we can find out A1? So denominator of A1 is as it is, that is the Z plus 1, and multiply with the Z plus 1, there is a X of Z into Z. So what is our X of Z into Z? This equation, just put it here, that is Z plus 3 divided by Z plus 1 into Z plus 2, and the value of Z is given, Z is equal to minus 1, okay, this Z is equal to minus 1. So just put, so if we see this Z plus 1 and Z plus 1 gets cancelled, and put Z is equal to minus 1 in these two terms, so we are getting A1 is equal to 2, okay. So ultimately we can find out by using the same procedure A2. So A2 is what? Again, denominator of A2 into X of Z divided by Z. So this is our X of Z divided by Z at what? At Z is equal to minus 2, okay. At Z is equal to minus 2. These are nothing but the roots, okay. We can say poles or P1, P2. So just put this Z is equal to minus 2 in this equation. If we see this term and this term gets cancelled, and put Z is equal to minus 2 in this two term, so we are getting A2 is equal to minus 1, okay. So in this way we find out the value of A1, that is 2, and value of A2, that is minus 1. Just put these values, okay, just put these values in the in this equation, okay, just put this value in this equation. So we are getting upon Z plus 1 plus, okay, this minus minus become plus 1 upon Z plus 2. Multiply this Z to this side, okay, multiply this Z to this side, so it becomes 2Z divided by Z plus 1 plus Z upon Z plus 2, okay. So as we know the standard formula of the inverse Z transform, so what was the standard formula of the inverse Z transform? We have seen in the last problem. So this is the standard formula of the inverse Z transform, that is Z upon Z minus PK is equal to PK into U of N. So just use this formula. So by using the inverse Z transform formula, we are getting this two as it is into Z upon Z plus 1, which is nothing but the 1 into U of N, again this minus, then this 2 into U of N, okay, this 2 into U of N. So this is nothing but the inverse Z transform, that is X of N of the given sequence. So in this way we find out the inverse Z transform of these two problems, okay, using partial fraction expansion method. So you should prepare more example and try to solve on your own as many as possible examples, okay. So this practicing will be perfect for the to solve so many examples on the long division method and partial fraction expansion method, okay. So in this way we have covered the inverse Z transform. So next session will be the new chapter of the digital signal processing. Thank you.